We're back at it again with another Battlefront update. So, another week goes by and still no Scarif update, but fortunately for us, there is light at the end of the tunnel, and it shouldn't be too long now. At the same time, while news has been rather dry lately, the devs continued to tease the community with even more new potential skins last week. And it was no different this week with the latest tease that came straight from DICE's hero designer. In this video, we'll be going over exactly that, when Scarif will be coming out, and as well the future of Battlefront 2. As always, we'll be covering all of this and more in today's video. And before we get into any of that, but a quick reminder. As if you do like these type of videos, then do remember to give it a like to show your support for not only this update series, but also the content within it. With that out of the way, let's get into it. Starting things off, if you've been paying attention to the Battlefront 2 news scene last week, then you'll know DICE hero designer Guillaume Raz put everything in motion with this little cryptic tweet of a blurry image with something reddish in it. And surprise, surprise, it didn't take too long for the Battlefront 2 community to figure out that this image was actually one of Darth Maul's horns. More specifically, Maul's horn from the Twin Suns episode from the Rebels animated series. Now, we knew very well that the chances of us getting a new Maul skin in the Scarif update were incredibly high, but no one knew exactly what kind of Maul skin we'd be getting. So if Guillaume's tease here suggests that it will be the Twin Suns Maul that is coming with Scarif, then great. Hopefully that mystery is solved. But things didn't stop there, as Guillaume then this week replied with a new tweet with the following. Did you think I was protecting something? No. Someone. Well played, everyone. There's a some days left, let's do a new one. So, it goes without saying that the first line here is a quote straight from the Twin Suns episode by Kenobi to Maul, and Guillaume admitting that we did in fact correctly guess what his blurry image tease stood for. He then of course went on to post a whole new image with the community once again figuring it out. And just this time, the image was actually from the Rise of Skywalker Palpatine movie screenshot. And yeah, I know this isn't the Senate skin for Palpatine that everyone really wanted the most, but hey. I'd still say it's a pretty snazzy looking appearance and kinda feels like a combination of his prequels and original trilogy outfits. Not to mention, just something for Palpatine is better than getting nothing at all. Now, I speculated a few months ago that Palps would likely be getting his Rise of Skywalker appearance put into the game, especially if he were to be ported over to the sequel trilogy era for Supremacy and Co-op. As at the time, Ben revealed that DICE were looking into adding Chewie into the sequel trilogy due to him basically looking the same and having the same playstyle. So of course, it goes without saying that Palpatine would also likely be the dark side candidate that would be ported over as well. And with Guillaume now teasing Palpatine's Rise of Skywalker appearance, then who knows? They may now be finally doing it. But even with that all said, I always like to remind everyone that these teases don't automatically mean confirmation. Yeah, are the chances high that we're gonna be getting a Twin Suns Maul and Rise of Skywalker Palpatine? Sure, no one can deny that, not even the trolls at this point. But for now, that's all they really are, nothing but potential teases. And unless Guillaume goes to straight out confirm these by saying, yes, we're gonna be adding these skins into the game, or they come included in the community transmission, then they aren't by any means confirmed. The same obviously can be said for leaks too. Next on the docket, we're gonna be going over the release of the Scarif update and when we should be expecting it. Now, this is a question I've been getting non-stop, both here and on social media, so it makes sense to add this in here too. Considering we haven't heard anything at all from DICE this week, and for sure we won't tomorrow, because DICE always now release the community transmission a day before the update itself, then it's 100% safe to say that both the community transmission and the update will be coming out next week, in the last week of the month, like in typical DICE fashion. as for any further delays, I very much doubt we'll be getting a third delay for Scarif, especially with Guillaume telling us that Scarif will be here in some days. And that's days, not weeks. So if he's confident enough to publicly tell us that, then it would seem that everything is going according to plan with Scarif's late April release. And whether we may like it or not, this is a smart decision in DICE's part. As had they released Scarif earlier in April, then by late April, everyone would be asking for the April update to come out. So, by having Scarif come out on either next Tuesday or Wednesday, then at that point, they don't have to worry about getting such questions, as April will be practically over by then, and whatever they did have planned for April, they can instead save that for May or June. Speaking about June, DICE also today announced the future plans of their main studio flagship game, Battlefield 5, stating that in addition to wrapping up the current Into the Jungle chapter in the game on April 29th, they will also be releasing one more game update for it later in June, and then stop their live service support for Battlefield 5. And as you can imagine, this news hasn't gone down too well with the Battlefield community, whom are rightfully furious after hearing that Battlefield 5 support is ending in the summer. And this kind of reminded me of the Battlefront 2 situation, where because two devs left, many people were panicking that Battlefront 2 support would be abruptly ending after Scarif. Now, while I don't personally think Battlefront 2 will be getting supported in, say, 2021, I'm still confident we'll be seeing updates for the remainder of this year. This is because, unlike Battlefront 2, DICE have already announced a new Battlefield game in the works, so they need the rest of their main team to eventually stop whatever they're doing on Battlefield 5 in order to work on the new Battlefield game. And even then, Battlefield 5 is still getting support to June or July if we take delays into consideration. So, for us, especially seeing as there has been no Battlefront 3 announced, unlike Battlefield 6 or whatever it's gonna be called, then this at least tells us that Battlefront 2 should be also seeing some updates this summer and then later after that, on account that DICE don't need to pull their Battlefront 2 team to work on a Battlefront 3. Now, granted, anything could still change. That's the case of the gaming industry, especially with DICE's secret Star Wars project that Ben Walk may or may had not joined as a producer. But point here being is that yes, Battlefront 2 should be seeing new updates after Scarif comes out, as at the moment, there is no reason for them not to do so, especially with Battlefront 2 performing much better than Battlefield 5. And if Battlefield 5, a game whose support is ending this summer, is still getting a new update during that time, then there's absolutely no reason to believe Battlefront 2 won't either, especially with DICE promising a return back to the Clone Wars after all is said and done. Last but not least, EA Tom has unveiled this weekend's in-game event, which is another Battle Point event with Heroes Unleashed, running from April 24th to the 27th. Players will have 9 heroes on each side available to play at 75% off their normal battle point costs. Also, double XP is still on for the rest of April as well. Now, seeing as this could also maybe be the last event we do get in April too, then it does kinda make you scratch your head on what was really going on with all those delays of the community calendar, especially considering as we never did get one yet for April. And honestly, at this point, it would be completely pointless, as we're headed to the last week of April now. Maybe, just maybe, there could still be one more event next week, like say April 28th to May 4th, that deals with something specific and new within the Scarif update, sure. Although, at the same time, if that were to be the case, then they should have known from the beginning that they weren't going to be releasing a community calendar this month at all, especially if it contained spoilers for the next update. Either way, whatever happened behind the scenes at DICE, hopefully they take this as a learning experience and come back better and stronger than ever in May. But that'll do it for this Battlefront update. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel to not only support it, but keep up with Star Wars news, gaming, and canon lore released every week. And consider following me on Twitter and Facebook to never miss out on the latest Star Wars content. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.